Continue with some of the halachot of Chazarat Hashatz. Very interesting halacha. There's a gemara in Masechet Berachot Daf Memhei. The gemara says, "Ha'one amen lo yagbia kolo yoter me'amevarich." That if when a person answers amen, he's not allowed to answer. He's not allowed to raise his voice above the one who's making the beracha. The Shulchan Aruch quotes it in Siman Kuf Chavdalet. Asur, yeah, asur for a person to raise his voice over the person who's making the beracha. The Mishnah Berurah brings down that it's not only answering Amen, it's answering any Dibre Kedusha, whether it's Barechu, or Kadosh Kadosh, Zimun, whatever it is that a person's answering, you're never allowed to overpower the one who's making the Beracha, or the one who's starting the Chazan. The reason for that is, there's a Pasuk, the Pasuk says, Gadelu l'Adonai iti, umiromema shemo yachdav. Iti and yachdav means together, not one above the other. So for that reason, a person can't do that. Not only that, the Gemara also tells us in Masechet Berachot, "Le'olam te'e da'ato shel Adam me'orevet im abriyot." A person shouldn't stick out. Right? If the Chazan is saying at a certain level, for a person to scream out and to jump out on another level is not, you have to be in tandem together with the Shliach Tzibur or whoever else is making the Beracha. A person shouldn't scream over him. Especially since sometimes when a person screams over the Chazan or whoever else is making the Beracha, sometimes it can startle the Chazan, it can confuse him, overpower. Person has to be, same thing with the Kohanim. Yeah, the Kohanim shouldn't scream over the Shliach Tzibur. Everyone should try to be together. Everyone should try to be on the same level, on the same frequency, in order to fulfill this halacha. I saw a very interesting safik. Some of the poskim bring down. Well, if the pasuk says that everybody has to say together, is a person allowed to answer amen lower than the Shliach Tzibur? That's it. Certainly you're not allowed to go higher. You can't go louder than the Shliach Tzibur. But are you allowed to go lower than the Shliach Tzibur? If the Shliach Tzibur says, Baruch Atah Hashem, whatever, right? Is a person allowed to answer amen quieter? So I saw certain posting being, bring that besafik. Some say you have to answer the same level, the same, at the same octave as the Chazan, but others, you don't see other people being makpid about that. As long as you don't answer higher, it's mutar. It's a very, very big musar that a person, no matter what he's doing, whether it's answering amen or praying or whatever it is, a person has to be cognizant, you have to be aware of your surroundings. There's other people, there's a shliach tzibur, there's a kahal. Sometimes a person doesn't realize, as it's probably coming from a good place, from the Shem Shamayim. A person wants to pray, beit lahavut, beit rakshut, but as a result, he's knocking out the shliach tzibur. He's knocking out the rest of the tzibur. Just what? The person in his mind, he's answering. The person has to be, le'olam te'e da'ato shel adam me'orevet me'briyot. Everybody has to be, realize where they are. Dalik nemi ata omed. There's other people around, there's a shliach tzibur. Not to, in football, you can do tackle. In football, you do tackle. You know what that is? In shliach tzibur, when it comes to tefillah, you don't tackle anybody. Not the shliach tzibur, not the kahal, no tackles. Right, leave that for football and for hockey. Yom Tov.